Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. For today's video, I have yet another Charlotte Tilbury review. I feel like we've had a lot of these recently, but I'm going to be reviewing her brand new Pillow Talk Lip and Cheek Glow. So if you're interested in hearing my thoughts on them, this is a first impressions. I'm not even wearing it right now. Then just keep watching. Yet again with another random release from Charlotte Tilbury. You know, we all just get a notification in our email, early access, and then so she came out with this, but actually I was really excited about this. This is the Pillow Talk Lip and Cheek Glow. So this is a new addition into her Pillow Talk collection, but these don't actually have Pillow Talk names. I will go over that in a second, but I guess they do have Pillow Talk based colors, which any kind of nudie pink color is Pillow Talk. By the way, I wanted to wear this cute top because it went with my eyeshadow and it's not even showing. And if you are curious about the eyeshadow that I'm wearing, a tutorial will be up this Saturday because so fun for summer. Anyways, back into this baby. So this is $40. It does say limited edition on her website, but for the most part, limited edition means it stays a pretty long time. And there are two different shades. I only purchased one. I'm trying to be better about spending my money because $40 is a lot. So I got the lighter shade, which is Color of Dreams, and then the darker shade is Color of Passions. There are already a bunch of great reviews that do feature both colors, so I will link a couple down below that I come across. So let me describe the product for you. This is the secret to fresh, radiant blush and Pillow Talk glow for everyone everywhere. Okay, her website's doing too much. It's a cream product that you can use on your lips and cheeks. You can use any cream product on your lips and cheeks, by the way. You can use a lipstick on your cheeks. So it's just a cream product. We suggest using it here and here. As far as ingredients go that they list, this has film-forming emollients, glossy ester for added gloss and texture, silky mica for soft gliding effect for a silky smooth finish, micronized powders delivers enhanced blendability and smoothness, raspberry leaf stem cell extract known for its moisturizing properties, vitamin E, and beeswax for a rich, smooth texture with softening properties. I mean, I think by now we do know her claims to all these ingredients are pretty normal. Whoever writes for her, they do a good job. Let's just get into it. I haven't even touched this baby. The packaging is this rose gold, very, very luxe packaging as per usual. It does feel a little bit cheaper. It feels like a plastic component, but it looks spectacular. By the way, while I'm staring at it, this has an 18-month shelf life and it is made in Italy. There also is a little mini mirror in here, and then of course you have the product. It does have a very slight vanilla fragrance to it, but nothing overwhelming. Like, I have to really inhale to smell it. Another thing to note that is very important about this product, and this isn't a secret for Charlotte Tilbury by now, but we've all figured out that her price per gram is usually astronomical. So if you're a person who uses up your makeup products, this really does affect you because you don't get a lot of product based on the amount that you pay, and that is comparing it to other products on the market. So this one is no exception. It's actually quite annoying how high the price per gram is. I'm gonna link you to Tara Lynn's video down below. She does a great job of explaining the price per gram and comparing it to other items on the market. Essentially, you are getting 0.08 ounces of product. You are spending $40 on this product, and it is $14.29 per gram. That is crazy, you guys, because for reference, and I'm getting this from Tara's video because I'm too lazy to do math, but the Fenty Cheeks Out Cream Blush is $20, so that's half the price. But just, again, for reference, price per gram is $6.67. Why is this $14? That is crazy. Again, if you're a person who uses a lot of product, I wouldn't go in this direction solely for that reason, unless the quality of this is absolutely breathtaking, which we are about to find out now. So again, like I said, I have Color of Dreams. So it does have a little bit of pull to it, meaning my skin doesn't glide on it. It's not super emollient, but as my finger warmed it up, it definitely got a little bit more smooth. And here is how the color is looking. So I do see we definitely have some pigment. We definitely have some shine, and it does feel a little bit sticky. I'm going to use my finger on one side and then a sponge on the other. So let's zoom you on in. My foundation was acting a little bit weird here, so just ignore that. Something about the products did not like each other. So I'm gonna warm my finger up in here. You definitely wanna use your finger to warm it up so that the product spreads better, but I have it on these two fingers. And let's blend it out. So I did set my T-zone area, meaning my under eyes, my nose, smile lines, with a translucent powder. So there is some powder residue probably on my face, but I did not directly put powder onto my cheek. And that really blended into the skin quite beautifully. That did not take a lot of effort at all. But that being said, we don't have a large amount of pigmentation, but this is like really soft and natural looking. It actually looks really good. I'm gonna see if putting on a second layer looks really nice. Yeah. And I will say, this does give a really gorgeous glow. Let me look closer. It does not seem to be pulling up my foundation at all, which is a big no-no for me. Ooh, I actually like that. That's very, very pretty. So I'm gonna go in with a sponge. This is typically how I apply these types of products. So I just am using my Kaleido sponge. I dipped it in a couple times. So I am getting a decent amount of payoff. I do think this does have like a nice buildable formula. If you aren't too crazy about color, you can get a really light wash, especially when you use your fingers. If you want something a little bit more heavy duty, I would use a sponge. I always prefer a sponge. I think this looks better. I think it's blending it in better. And this color is really pretty. So that blended in really nice, you guys. It applied really nice. So as far as application, this is gorgeous. I'm gonna give it a second to kind of settle in. While we're waiting, I'm going to apply it to my lips. I would say this is basically my lip color. I don't know if it's not pigmented. Any foundation or anything that was on my lips is getting covered by this. This is actually nice to just throw on if you're not even wearing any makeup or just some mascara. I don't see this having any sort of lasting power on my lips. I don't think I would use this as a lipstick or as a lip color, but it kind of just brings life back to my face. Again, foundation that gets over it brings the color back, but it looks like my lips, so I wouldn't say anything as special about wearing it on the lips, to be honest, but it looks fine. But I definitely prefer it on the cheeks. But if you are without lip color, I mean, this is fine just to add some life to your face, but I wouldn't say this is amazing for the lips. It doesn't feel particularly moisturizing either. It doesn't feel drying either. It's just kind of there, and it just brought some pigment back to my lips. But on the cheeks is where we are really working it. From what I've seen of the reviews of the deeper color, it seems that the tone on the face is the same, but you do get more pigmentation from the deeper one. So if you have, I would say, a medium to deep skin tone, I would choose that color, though I'm not sure how that deeper color would work on deep skin tones. I'm very curious. So if I find a video of somebody with a deeper complexion, I will link that below because I can't speak on that right now. This color on my light complexion, I'm very happy with. I do feel like it did kind of disappear a little bit. I want a brighter color. As far as how it's feeling on the cheeks, it does feel a little bit more tacky. I don't think it's a formula that is going to set down or turn to powder or anything like that. So if you are wearing a mask, and I think it's crazy that I have to mention this in videos nowadays based on what the world has come to, but if you're wearing a mask, I'll put a little bit of powder over there just so that it doesn't transfer or it lessens the probability of transferring. I mean, longevity could really affect my thoughts on this product, and I mean, I'll tell you if that completely changes my whole perspective on this product. But I think it's a nice product, but I have to admit, just based on this first initial application, I don't think it's worth it. I didn't notice anything special compared to any of my other cream products that I have in my collection. I prefer my Patrick Ta, which is a better value. I think the Fenty is a bit better as well. So I'm gonna quickly bring you over to some swatch comparisons, and then I'll meet you back for the outro. All right, you guys, so I did compare some of my cream blushes that I thought you guys would be interested in. So here is the Charlotte Tilbury Color of Dreams. Then I have Rose Latte from Fenty. Then I have Rose Pink from Honest Beauty. Then I have Naughty and Spice from Nude Sticks. Then I have 8th Muse Intensity from Kosas. We have Cool Berry from Fenty. This was an afterthought. That's why the other Fenty is over here. And then lastly, I have my Milk Makeup, which I can't remember which one this is, so I will have the text right here. As far as formulation goes, what I definitely noticed noticed is Charlotte Tilbury is definitely much more glossy than the other options that I have swatched for you. So it does feel more tacky upon touch, but it doesn't get as sticky as your finger warms it up. I noticed a lot of the others felt more powdery. Even the Fenty felt a little bit more powdery. The closest formula I would say is Honest Beauty as far as glossiness and texture goes. But other than that, here are some color comparisons, swatch comparisons, so you can see. Like I said, I don't notice anything really unique and amazing about the formula to justify how much more expensive it is price per gram compared to all of these others. If you are looking for some more amazing swatch comparisons of other formulas and other colors as well from other brands, again, I want to send you over to Tara Lynn's video. She did a fabulous job on her video. She went into detail. She compared a lot of different formulas and colors, so her video is very useful. I just used kind of what I had. Overall, my thoughts on this product... The product itself is good. It's a nice cream product, but just looking at the other values of other brands, I cannot recommend this product for you. If you're looking into the new released cream blush kind of products, I would send you in the way of Patrick Ta. A Fenty is nice. I just think that it breaks me out. Nude Sticks has a beautiful formula. I also really enjoy the Kosas cream blush formula. I mean, now that I have this, I absolutely will enjoy it. I will wear it. I'm a Charlotte Tilbury fan. I do not regret purchasing it. But in the grand scheme of makeup and as a makeup review, I cannot recommend this to you. It's not worth how expensive it is. We kind of got duped with this product, if I'm being honest. She gave us a very little amount of product for a big price, and there's nothing exceptional in this formula to really justify that. Guys, okay, so I actually decided to give you guys a wear test update. So it's actually about 5 o'clock. So I've been wearing the blush now for about 6 hours, not quite as long as I would normally like, but I need to take my makeup off and work out. But some things that I've noticed, and I thought that this would be valuable for you guys, a lot of the color has come off on my cheek. Like, I just not come off, but it's faded. I do have that really pretty glossy finish that this gives to the skin. It's not like highlighty, but it's more just dewy, glowy prettiness. It's not overly glowy, but I do think if you have a more oily skin type, I would suggest probably setting it. I can't speak as somebody who has oily skin, so this might be incorrect, but just what I'm seeing on my face, I think you might benefit from setting it with a little extra blush or maybe just running some translucent powder over top. I'm not a big fan of the fact that the color has faded though. I have some other cheek products that I feel like handle the color better, but as far as the way that it's sitting on the skin, it looks really pretty. As far as the finish goes, this is a product that I definitely would want to wear on more natural makeup days because the way that it settles into the skin after a few hours is very pretty. Even though the color does fade, there still is a remaining amount of color to where I don't look dead. It still looks really nice, and I do really like the finish. Overall though, of course, for the price, it's not all that. It's not mind-blowing. It's a good product for sure, but definitely not worth it. So if anything changes in wear time as I continue to wear this and my opinions change from today's update, I will be sure to put that in a pinned comment for you guys. But this is first day, first impressions, wear kind of thoughts, and it's okay. I hope you guys enjoyed this review. I hope you found it helpful. Let me know your thoughts below about this product. If you aren't subscribed to my channel already, I would love it if you would take the time to do so. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye guys, have a good one.